And it came to pass that as they went in the way, a certain man said to him, Lord, I will follow you wherever you go. This is really close to what someone said to him after he gave the parable. Of sowing the seed and the weed and the tares and other parables. But I compared these two, and it clearly says his location here. Other villages on his way to Jerusalem. And he just left a Samaritan village. But earlier, it was a totally different scenario. A certain scribe. Here it just says, a certain man. The man is in italics, so you just say, a certain said to him, Lord, I will follow you wherever you go. He had just left a Samaritan village. You'd be hard-pressed to find scribes there. You'd expect them to be in Jerusalem, right? And not living in Samaria? His response is exactly the same, which does make it kind of annoying that I'd have to put it twice. Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has not where to lay his head. Earlier, foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has not where to lay his head. It's exactly the same. I really do want to combine these two, but they are clearly different events.
Now it comes to it, I've been dreading this moment for years. I knew I'd have to get to it again, answering why these two statements would probably be different, or change it and make them the same and put them where Matthew has it or where Luke has it. The first most basic bits of reasoning to think they're different is that they are timed different. Matthew has it way earlier, right before he crosses over to heal the Gadarene demoniac. And in Matthew, it actually says, chapter 8, verse 18, Now when Jesus saw great multitudes about him, he gave commandment to depart to the other side. Then, verse 19, And a certain scribe came and said to him, Master, I will follow you wherever you go. And he gives his answer. He gave commandment to depart to the other side. Would that make sense if he's departing from a city? Depart to the other side of what? The other side of the town? He's already leaving. When he's departing from a town, you're not departing to the other side of the town. That refers to him crossing over the lake, Tiberias, or the Sea of Galilee. And that was the scenario in Matthew. He was about to go over the Sea of Tiberias. So the scene seems to be that he's about to cross over the lake, not that he's in Samaria. And also that other bit of evidence with the scribe seemed more likely he would be around the Sea of Galilee than in Samaria. But in order to be diligent, I looked up all the other gospel harmonies that I have, and I found that they quite thoroughly disagree with each other. So concerning this issue with the scribe and the disciple who asked to follow Jesus, but Jesus gives a warning and a refusal between Matthew 8, 19 through 22 and Luke 9, 57 through 62. Those who believe these scenarios should be combined, but don't give an opinion as to where. I only found one, the Jameson Fawcett Brown Bible Commentary on Bible Hub. It says it in a note in Matthew 8:21 commentary, the procrastinating or entangled disciple. Those that keep together these two passages, scribe and others ask to follow Jesus, and he responds, nowhere to lay his head, on and on, and move the passage in Luke to Matthew's timing, just before crossing the sea towards the Gadarene demoniac, include A Harmony of the Gospels by John H. Kerr, The Harmony of the Gospels by St. Augustine, The Dietes Ronifitation, and the Benson Commentary, Luke 9, 57 through 62. Those who believe the passages should be combined, but moved from Matthew's timing to Luke's timing, include the Four Gospels in Four Fonts and One Story by Camolo, The Life of Christ in Stereo by Johnston M. Cheney, Pulpit Commentary in Bible Hub, The Merged Gospels by Gary Crossland, The Word by James H. Jenkins, The Gospel in Life by A.T. Robertson, A Composite Gospel by Dr. Michael E. Brown, The Gospel of Jesus by Marshall Thomas, and he does something interesting. He does not combine the verses from Luke, but only replaces them with Matthew. And he entirely leaves out Luke 9, 61 to 62, which is the third person that asks to follow Jesus. Where in Matthew, there are only two different times people ask. In Luke, there were three. He leaves off this third without any explanation. These next three, The Word Became Flesh by Paul Oman, The Story of Jesus in Harmony with the Gospels by Justin Brother, and All About Jesus by Roger Kai, all three of these, like Marshall Thomas, do not combine the passages from Matthew and Luke into one, but they choose one passage over the other. Unlike Marshall Thomas's work, these choose Luke's passage instead of Matthew's, so they don't leave off that last interaction, but they leave out the different wording from Matthew, that it was a scribe. Now those gospel harmonies who keep both passages in each context and have them repeat include the Chronological Gospel by Michael Rood, the Gospels in Harmony by Dale Lovercheck, the 4-in-1 Gospel of Jesus by Nikola Dimitrov, and the Fourfold Gospel by McGarvey, and this one has a note that the first statement may belong only where Matthew has it, but both the second and third statements from Luke belong only where Luke has it, as if both those gospel authors moved something in order for similarly themed statements to be together. So it's all over the place. Plenty of scholars, plenty of researchers have different opinions. A lot of them put these statements only where Matthew has it. A lot of them put them only where Luke has it. And some that I would consider the most researched, like the Chronological Gospels by Michael Rood and the 4-in-1 Gospel of Jesus by Nikola Dimitrov, have them repeat. Since these different scholars have differing opinions, I think there's plenty of reason to go with one or the other. I'm going to side with my original decision, which was to actually keep them separate, to have two different times that Jesus made these statements. Even though it might be a little bit annoying, it's probably more accurate. There is enough reason to believe that they're different, so I'll just leave them as two different events. And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has not where to lay his head." And he said to another, "Follow me." You know, where it says here, "and he said to another," it doesn't clearly say this is at this time. This might be something like what Matthew is doing. He's combining similar events together. And I really do think Luke is doing some of this between chapters 9 and 18, because there's a whole bunch of stuff Jesus says that repeats from earlier in Mark and Matthew. So I think I'm going to move this over to the earlier event. I have to leave the first one, "Foxes have holes, birds of the air have nests," because it's saying they're in Samaria, and this is just a man. As they went in the way, on the way that they're already going, a certain man said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." This would be different. But where it just says, "and he said to another," it doesn't say in the way for this event.
I think this might be okay to combine with the time earlier from Matthew and Mark. The response in Matthew is he says, "Follow me and let the dead bury their dead." In Luke, it says, "Let the dead bury their dead, but go you and preach the kingdom of God." Huh. Okay, that's different. And I think that's too different to combine. Because in Matthew, he was inviting the guy to come along with him. It was one of his disciples. And I think this might have actually been one of the 12. That's when he entered into a boat, his disciples followed him. However, this time in Luke, Jesus is sending the guy saying, "Go you and preach the kingdom of God." He's not saying, "Come with me," he's saying, "Go." But he did say, "Follow me." You know what? I think I'll leave it here in Luke. The fact that he said, "Go you and preach the kingdom of God," that changed my mind. He did say follow at the beginning, but then he said go and preach. It wouldn't quite seem right for the situation in Matthew where they're getting into a boat. He wouldn't say go and preach, and then they all got into a boat and went and exorcised the demons out of the Gadarene demoniac. Yeah, I'll just leave these as separate. Follow me. He said, "Lord, permit me first to go and bury my father." Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their dead, but go you and preach the kingdom of God." "Lord, I will follow you, but let me first go bid them farewell, which are at home at my house." No man, having put his hands to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God.